हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, इट इज योर सिक्स सेमेस्टर एंड देर आर फोर यूनिट्स इन इट. फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल आर के नारायण्स फेमस नॉवेल द गाइड, सेकेंड इज क्राई द पिकॉक एंड थर्ड इज महाभारता विच वॉज कंपोज बाय सी राजगोपालाचारी. एंड इन फोर्थ यूनिट देर आर फोर एसेज फ्रॉम द कलेक्टेड एसेज. नाउ वी विल स्टार्ट द फर्स्ट नॉवेल ऑफ आर के नारायण, The guide. R. K. Narayan, who was a great storyteller and a novelist, he present as in as simple words as are used in the daily conversation or daily used language. He belonged to the Mysore and he create a town which is named as Malgudi. And that creation became immortal by his stories and his novels. Malgudi is an imaginary town, and it is situated in southern India. And all the stories of R. K. Narayan are went through this the background of this village. Author R. K. Narayan. Country India and language of this novel is English. Philosophical novel and publisher is Viking Press U.S. and Maiden U.K. Publication date 1958. This novel got a great success, and in 1965 there was a film was made by Devanand, and it got a great success. It was made in both English and Hindi, and it got a great success at that time. These are the famous works which was composed by R. K. Narayan. First of all, English Teacher, The Missing Mail, and The Waiting for Mahatma. These are the great books of R. K. Narayan. Mr. Sampath, the printer of Malgudi, and Financial Expert, these are also the great books of R. K. Narayan. The Guide, as you know, it is the greatest book of R. K. Narayan. It is the greatest composition because it is it has the two meanings of the title. The Guide means the tourist guide, and second, the guide means the leader. The tourist guide converts in the spiritual leader at last in this novel. So we can say this is a philosophical novel. The Guide, it also has as a background the village Malgudi, and there is a railway station, and Raju is the guide who is the essential part of this village, and every tourist want Raju as their guide. His another book is Malgudi Days. Malgudi Days is a very famous book of R. K. Narayan, and there are many stories in this book, and all around there is the village and the railway station, the village square and the huts and the buildings, all are mentioned in this novel. R. K. Narayan's creation, the character Raju, is known as the immortal character of R. K. Narayan, because he was not a good person, but at last when he spent some time in jail and converted as a saint at last, and then he fast against the god for the rain, and the end is opening end. There is not the positive cannot said, and that and we cannot said that it is negative end, because it is an opening end, it is open end. We it is depend on the reader. There are some other stories as Malgudi Days, the sweet, the vendor of sweet, and Astrologer's Day. These are another books of R. K. Narayan. R. K. Narayan, who was born in 10 October 1906 and died in 13 May 2001, full name Rashipuram Krishnaswamy Iyer Narayan Swamy. Rashipuram is the name of the village where he was born, and Krishnaswamy Iyer the name of his father, and Narayan Swamy is his own name. But he used only Narayan as his name, R. K. Narayan. As we know that in south area, the name are as if we wrote them from the last, it became the address of the person. Narayan Swamy, son of Krishna Swamy Iyer from Rashipuram. This is the address and the name. Was an Indian writer best known for his works set in the fictitious South Indian town of Malgudi. He is one of three leading figure of trio Indian novelist of trio of English novelist, early Indian literature in English, alongside Mulk Raj Anand, Raja Rao, and R. K. Narayan, and is credited with bringing the genre of the rest of the world. R. K. Narayan, who composed many novels and stories, he is standing with the great Mulk Raj Anand and Raja Rao. Raja Rao, who is belong to the Gandhian India and wrote many novels for the as a background of Gandhian movements, as Kanthapura. Mulk Raj Anand, who is also a great novelist, and there are two novels, Untouchable and Coolie, which are very most popular novels in Indian literature. Narayan broke through with the help of his mentor and friend Graham Greene, who was instrumental in getting publisher for Narayan's first four books, including the semi-autobiographical trilogy of Swami and Friends, The Bachelor of Arts, and The English Teacher. These are the semi-biographical trilogy of Swami R.K. Narayan. Narayan's works also include The Financial Expert, hailed as one of the most original work of 1951, and Sahitya Academy Award winner, The Guide, which was adapted for film and for Broadway. So we can say that R.K. Narayan is a great, successful writer of independent India and independent India, because he got a great success. And he Graham Greene was the mentor and friend of R.K. Narayan, and he contribute and he wrote the preface for all his four starting books. And we can say that R.K. Narayan is a great successful writer in India as a storyteller, as a novelist, and as a good writer. The Guide is, in 1958, novel written in English by the Indian author R.K. Narayan. Like most of his work, the novel is based in Malgudi, the fictional town in South of India. The novel describes the transformation of protagonist Raju. Raju is the protagonist of this novel, and it shows the transformation of the Raju. Raju was a guide and converted and transformed in a real leader or a sadhu. From a tour guide to a spiritual guide, and then one of the greatest holy men of India. The novel brought its author the 1960 Sahitya Academy Award for English by the Sahitya Academy, India's National Academy of Letters. It is the academy who gave the Sahitya Academy Awards for all languages in India, for 22 languages in India, and for English. In 1960, Sahitya Academy Award was given to Mr. R.K. Narayan. He got a great success by this novel, and at last he got the Sahitya Academy Award in 1960. Summary of this novel. Raju, who was called Railway Raju. Its nickname, Railway Raju, and the original name is Raju, is a disarmingly correct guide who falls in love with a beautiful dancer, Rosie, the neglected wife of archaeologist Marco. Marco doesn't approve of Rosie's passion for dancing because he doesn't like it. He said that it is the work of beggar or harlots. Rosie, encouraged by Raju, and decides to follow her dreams and start a dancing career. They start living together, and Raju's mother, as she does not approve of their relationship, leaves them. This is the starting of the novel. Raju starts as a guide at the railway station, and Marco, who was the husband of Rosie, doesn't like the dancing of Rosie and always condemned her for her dance and said that you need not dance to anymore because I have earned many money, there much money, and we didn't need any money. But Rosie take the dance as a passion, and Raju helped her to gain the identity as a dancer of the national dancer. Raju helps her. And at last we see that Rosie and Raju both get the success in their career, and Raju became the secretary of Rosie, and Rosie became the classical great dancer of India. And this and they lived together at the Raju's house, and the mother of Raju became very furious and then left the house because she does not approve their relationship. They lived without married. They lived without married life, and it is a sinful life according to the mother of Raju. Raju becomes Roji's stage manager, and soon with the help of Raju's marketing tactics, Roji becomes a successful dancer. Raju, however, develops an inflated sense of self-importance and tries to control her. Raju gets involved in a case of forgery and gets a 2-year sentence. After completing the sentence, Raju passes through a village where he is mistaken for a sadhu, a spiritual guide. This is the climax of the story. Raju is sentenced for 2 years for a forgery because he has forged the sign of Rosie on a document which was sent by Marco. Marco, the husband of Rosie, sent her the garments, can be said not garments, it is jewelry, sent the jewelry to Rosie, and the Raju accepted it with a forged sign, and Marco noticed it and then make a case against Raju, and then he was sentenced of 2 years in the jail. When he come out from the jail, he passes through a village where he is mistakenly identified as a sadhu, as a spiritual guide by a person, a villager. So we can say Raju is confusedly known as a sadhu by a villager, and then the whole country recognized him as a great sadhu, as a great spiritual leader, a great spiritual guide. Recently, as he does not want to return in disgrace of Malgudi, he stayed in an abandoned temple. There is a feminine in the village, and Raju is expected to keep a fast in order to make it rain. With media publicizing his fast, huge crowd gather, much to Raju's resentment, to watch him fast. After fasting for several days, he goes to the riverside one morning as part of his daily ritual, where his legs shake down as he feels that the rain is falling in the hills. This is the last scene of this novel. As we know, this is a spiritual change in the character of Raju. When he goes to the river side for the daily rituals, where his legs shake down as he feels that the rain is falling in the hills, and he dead. This is a very open end. The rain is in the mind of Raju, or it is actual rain, it is on the thinking of the reader. It is openly ended, and the writer don't say that it is rain or not, it is imagination or not. He doesn't have any comment on this topic. Raju, who was a cheater, in his early life, he was a fraud in his early life, became a spiritual saint at last. There are many characters which are liked by the readers. First of all, Raju and Rosie, then Marco, and then his mother's and mother's brother, and then the child who tackled the shop of Raju, and there is a character, the farmer, who make Raju the saint or the sadhu, the spiritual guide, and many minor characters are also there. So we can say that this is a great novel which shows about the transformation of a guide into a guide, into a tourist guide, the transformation of a tourist guide into a spiritual guide. Raju, who was a tourist guide, and then after a girl, he became a fraud man, and then at last, when he was sentenced of 2 years, he completely transformed his character into a spiritual saint, and at last he fasted against the god for the rain. He said that if god doesn't make or doesn't settle the rain, he will die by not eating any food, not touching any food, and at last she died. It is an open end which was given by the R.K. Narayan. And when was a movie was made on this novel, the rain is shown in the last scene, because the people always like the happy ending, and in the ending the rain was shown in the movie and Raju went die. The ending of the novel leaves unanswered the question of whether he dies or whether he lives, and whether the drought has really ended. The last line of the novel is, Raju said, Velan. Velan is the villager who find out the Raju as a spiritual guide. It's raining in the hills. I can feel it coming up under my feet, up my legs. He sagged down. It is an open ending. He died or not, it is not clearly. There is rain or not, it is not clear. There is the rain in the mind, it is not clear, because it is an imaginative end. It is suggested to the reader. Reader, find out what could be the end. Sorry. So we can say R. K. Narayan is a great novelist who took the subject of spirituality through a tourist guide who was a fraud, and at last he gave a great end of this novel. Now the summary. R. K. Narayan's novel The Guide is the story of a man named Raju who comes from a small village in India called Malgudi. Malgudi itself does not exist. This fact gives Narayan's novel the feeling of a fable or a fantasy. Raju's life is predicted on a series of self-depictions which eventually lead the character down a road of confusion and loss of self and the spiritual transformation and awakening. Throughout Raju's life, he does not his best to be whatever people require him to be at any given moment. What he runs a shop at the Malgudi train station, he is Railway Raju, an extraordinary guide and procurer of all things needed. When Raju meets a beautiful dancer named Rosie, he becomes her lover and her guide as well, by the helping Rosie realized her wish to dance professionally. When Rosie becomes famous, Raju then becomes Raj. It is a stylish name and a man of influence and elevated social standing. This does not last very long, however, and Raju eventually ends up in prison. While incarcerated, Raju again works his chameleon magic, whereby he becomes well-known and well-liked. However, Raju never seemed to understand the lesson life wishes for him to learn. The life wants to give him a great message, but he doesn't realize about it. As he being released from the prison, Raju finds himself wondering what to do with the rest of his life. He was confused. He don't know where to go. If he go to home, there was the rumors against him and Rosie and about his mother. And if he go to Rosie, he was shameful. It is very shameful because she rebuked him, and Raju has no desire to return to Malgudi to face gossip and rejection by the people or by his mother. He hides out in an abandoned temple on the banks of the Saryu River and buys himself a little bit of time. One day, a man named Velan appears at the temple, and through a series of conversation, Velan comes to regard Raju as some sort of a holy man. Velan, who is very in a great trouble, he wants to suicide himself because his sister always rebuked him and don't want to marry to anybody. Velan took her to Raju, and Raju then teach her, and at last the girl became ready to marry a person, and Velan became the disciple of Raju. Finding the situation beneficial, Raju plays along with the ruse. However, there comes a day when, due to some rather comical miscommunications, Raju is forced to reveal the truth about who he is and where he comes from. Raju believes that this act is disclosure will free him from playing the part of the accidental Swami. but it was just the opposite effect. Sitting in the ancient temple on the river bank, Raju's final incarnation is that of Swamiji, and Raju's metamorphosis occurs when he is finally able to release his need to be all things to all people. Some people born great and some people are forcibly made great, and Raju is one of them because he is not great, but he was made great. And when he fasted, he became purer and purer. At last, he became the complete spiritual leader, spiritual guide. He need to be all things to all people. He comes to an understanding of what it means to serve others selflessly. His entire life, Malgudi, Rosie, money and fame all fall away until finally Raju is left with nothing but the essence of himself as just another man. He completely transformed his personality. He became a spiritual guide. In starting, he was busy with Rosie and Malgudi. Then he earned money and fame. All fall away, all vanished until finally when he became a spiritual guide. He completely transformed from a tourist guide into a spiritual guide. It is at this point that Raju becomes the saint, and he has been playing all along. Raju is deception proved valuable after all, as he eventually acts his way into his true self, finally becoming able to sacrifice himself willingly in order to restore hope to the lives of others. And he brings a great hope for the persons who lived in that village, and at last he manages and he fasts against the god to relieve all the country persons or countrymen. It is a spiritual ending of the novel, and R.K. Narayan manages it's an open ending, because there we don't know that Raju became dead or not, or the rain come or not. It is an open ending and depend on the thinking way of the reader. Now the next is Mahabharata, which is composed by C. Rajagopalachari. C. Rajagopalachari, the first Indian governor of India in 1947 till 1950. C. Rajagopalachari, which is known as Chakravarti Rajagopalachari, informally called Rajaji or C.R., was an Indian lawyer, independence activist, politician, writer, and statesman. Rajagopalachari was the last Governor General of India and first Indian Governor General of India. Born on December 10, 1878, Thorapalli, and died in December 25, 1972, Chennai. These are the works of Chakravarti Rajagopalachari. The first book is Mahabharata, and then the Ramayana. There is a children, C.R. Narasimha, and awards he was awarded with Bharat Ratna, education at Bangalore University and Presidency College, Chennai. And people also search for his personality, because most of the people of India doesn't know that who was the ruler from 1947 to 1950. And now you know about it, that C.R. Chakravarti Rajagopalachari is the ruler of India from 1947 till 1950, 26 January. From 26 January 1950, India became a republican country, and the president, the prime minister of India is become the supremo, and the president of India become the supremo of the country. And there is the post of governor is completely demolished. Chakravarti Rajagopalachari, who was born in 10 December 1978, called Rajaji or CR, was an Indian lawyer, independence activist, politician, writer, statesman, and he was the last Governor General of India. He also served as leader of Indian National Congress, primer of the Madras Presidency, primer and Governor of West Bengal, Minister for Home Affairs of the Indian Union, and Chief Minister of Madras State. Rajagopalachari founded the Swatantra Party and was one of the first recipient of India's highest civilian award, the Bharat Ratna. He got it. And he vehemently opposed the use of nuclear weapons and was a proponent of world peace and disarmament. During his lifetime, he also acquired the nickname Mango of Salem. And now about the book, Mahabharata is a mythological book and it was basically composed by Ved Vyas. But later, Sri Rajagopalachari wrote this book in English, and it is a very popular book for the children because it has a sense of the great epic Mahabharata. It was the first publication by Bharatiya Vidya Bhavan in 1958, and this book is an abridged English retelling of Vyas Mahabharata. Rajaji considered this book as his Ramayana to be his greatest service to his countrymen. The writing style in this book is fluid and the words carry weight. As of 2001, the book had sold over 1 million copies. 10 lakh copies of this book has been sold till 2001. So we can say that it got a great, huge success. And he also wrote the Ramayana also in English, and it is a short translation of this book. So we can say Sri Rajagopalachari, who was a short storyteller and a writer, was a great writer of India and was the first governor of free India. Sri Rajagopalachari, who was the companion of J.L. Nehru, Jawaharlal Nehru, who was the first Prime Minister of India, and when in 26 January 1915 he was arranged to leave the chair of governor, he became very emotional and he said that it is his end. But later he made himself busy in writings, and then he write many stories for the children, and Mahabharata and Ramayana stories. There is a great story, the Nod Jewel, which is in your course. The Nod Jewel is a story about a husband and a wife and two sparrows. A male sparrow arranged, and he stole a nail, Nod Jewel, and threw it on the ground of the wife, and then wife took it and wear it. But suddenly when she learned about it, that it is another's property, she became very furious, and then she became ill, and the male sparrow gave a message that all wives should follow the talking of the husband, and they follow the rules which was made by the husband. It is a short story, and Mahabharata is a story about the Lord Krishna and Pandavas and Kauravas. And Ramayana is the story about the Ram, Sita and Lakshman and his two other brothers and the sons of King Dasharatha. So this is enough for today. Have a good day.